Hi. She hasn't regained consciousness yet.
Are the cranial x-rays back?
Yeah, a concussion with a hairline fracture of the dural bone, tear in the dura left side.
Is there much leakage?
It's under control. There's also a malalignment of the fifth cervical vertebra.
She's gonna need traction.
I'd planned to apply it after she regained consciousness.
Yeah, good.
Dr. Borlaug, there's something I'm confused about. Intracranial pressure seems apparent, but that would indicate a constriction of the pupils. I just checked, her pupils are dilated.
Mm. It's understandable. She's under the influence of hashish. Yeah, she ate some brownies her daughter made. She didn't know that Kim had spiked them.
Kim?
Yeah.
I don't understand. Why would she do something like that?
Well, she was trying to be helpful.
What?
The long story I'll tell you later.
Kim, look, your mother's gonna be fine, but I think it's a good idea for you to wait outside.
Yeah, that's all right. I'll just stay.
Oh.
Ray. Ray Woodard. Ray. Ray. Open your eyes for me. Can you do that?
No.
Now, come on, Ray. Open your eyes. There you go.
What happened to me?
Dear heaven, what's happened?
It's that brother of mine, Sean. Told you about him. You know the fellow with the pub in Lynch, County Clare?
Yes, of course.
Well, he's broken his leg in three places. His barman has gone off to Dublin with a group of rock musicians. So he wants me to come over and run the place while he's on the mend.
Oh, okay.
I suppose I'll have to do it, Maeve.
Yes, of course you will have to. How in the world did he break his leg?
At a party. And the doctor says he'll be off his feet for about 6 to 8 weeks.
He can be gone all that time?
Don't let it break your heart, Delia.
Well, I'm sorry, Kevin, for him and as well as for us. I don't relish the thought of running this place without you.
Well, just think of the money we'll save. That's all right, Kevin. You take all the time you need. I mean, broken legs can be very tricky.
And I'm going to miss the wedding.
Oh, dear, yes.
You know, the thing is that I know I take some of the burdens off your shoulder and I give John a bit of a release from the pressures too at times.
Yes, you do. Has he told you about Tiso Novotny's latest visit here?
Oh, he mentioned it once or twice.
I thought Tiso was very nice.
Well, I'm sure he was, but that doesn't ease John's mind about this marriage, let me tell you.
Well, I don't understand what Johnny's getting so upset about. I think Tiso's really sweet. And he's certainly not going to have any of us rubbed off or anything because... I mean, rub that. We're practically family.
All right, dear. That's enough of that kind of talk. I'm going to have a hard enough time keeping an even keel around these premises between now and the wedding. The less said about that situation, the better, particularly to John and Siobhan.
Maeve, I was only trying to help. I mean, I just...
Well, if you really are trying to help, why don't you go over there and take orders from those two people? Here, there's a pencil. Here you go.
All right. Better get used to it. You're going to need my help a lot while Kevin's on vacation.
Uh-huh.
It's okay. It's all right. You're gonna be all right.
I don't... Oh. Where is this?
You're in Riverside Hospital. There was an accident. But it's all right now. Do you remember what happened?
No, I don't. Where? Where is this?
What's your name? Tell me your name.
What? She can't.
Tell me your name.
I can't.
Come on.
Yes. Ray.
Good, good. You're doing fine.
Ray Woodard.
That's fine.
Seneca.
Hi.
What happened? lights coming at me. It's cars and lights.
Yeah, we'll talk about it later. Right now, the point is that you're going to get well. You'll be laid up for a while. You'll be uncomfortable as hell, but you're alive. You're very lucky.
Where are they? I was looking for them.
Mother.
Where?
Don't try to move your head. Lie perfectly still.
Where's Kimberly? I don't want to be alone anymore. I'm tired of being alone. I can't.
Kim's right here.
Where? Yes.
I told you not to move your head.
Okay. Yes, Mother. I'm so sorry.
Seneca says you shouldn't move.
I never meant for this to happen. I'm sorry.
Oh. Don't do that. It's not your fault. It's my fault. I went looking for you. I'm sorry.
It was my fault.
They all left me. I'm very glad to see you.
I did
no,
this.
No, not now. We'll talk later. Your mother has to sleep.
I...
Kimberly, no.
Seneca says you have to sleep, so... Seneca?
Yeah.
You take care of her. Somebody has to, and I couldn't.
I will.
No, I didn't want to.
Now, she'll be fine. Gonna take her home right now. Dr. Cohn's gonna be with you. You're in good hands. We'll come back in the morning.
Thank you.
I can't leave her.
Listen, there's nothing you can do for her here. Come on.
Please.
Kim, I'll take care of her, I promise. I'll be on duty all night. Now, don't worry.
She needed me, and I...
I'll let you know if there's any change. Now, I'm sure there won't be. She's out of danger, and she's going to sleep through the night. Come on, Kim, let's go.
Promise me.
Go ahead.
Night, Mother. I love you.
What a surprise. Mae, this is my commodities broker, Dan Fox. This is my ex-mother-in-law, Mae.
Mr. Fox.
Well, so you're the famous Maeve Ryan.
Am I?
Well, I've heard a great deal about you, and I should thank you. I know how much you've helped Delia with the commodities market.
Oh, yes. Well, don't thank me for that, please.
Oh, no, I should. If it wasn't for you, Delia and I might never have met.
Oh, this is Kevin McGinnis. He works here.
How are you, Mr. Fox?
Hello.
Well, this really is a surprise.
It shouldn't be.
Well, it is.
Well, Delia, you probably wouldn't want me to tell you this, but...
Well, don't then.
Oh, no, come on now. You shouldn't be embarrassed. It's just that this place is a very important part of Delia's life. She's told me so much about it and about all of you, I had to see it for myself. And I'm certainly glad I did. It's a wonderful bar. You just don't find many... authentic places like this left in the city. How long has it been in your family?
Well, let me see now. 22 years next spring.
Oh, you must be very fond of it.
Well, you might say that, yes.
You know, I've always dreamed of owning a place like this of my own. Well, maybe one day.
Let's sit down. Commodities are so exhausting. He works very hard.
I would love to.
Oh, not there. I mean... Let's be more comfortable. Here's a nice table.
Oh, fine. Excuse us.
Thank you. Yes. Mr. Fox, can I get you something from the bar?
Oh, yes, thank you. Scotch on the rocks would be fine.
All right.
Two specials, Maeve.
All right. Take care.
I will, yes.
Hello.
What are you doing here?
Well, I just told her. I came to see the bar.
But you can't.
Obviously, I can. Besides, if I don't have a right to be here, who does? What else do I have to show for my $50,000 investment?
Dan.
And as it's turned out, it wasn't such a bad business move on my part after all.
You promised that you wouldn't.
I might have foreclosed already, if it weren't for my faith in your ultimate good sense. I know you, Delia. I think very well. And I think that you will come to realize that continuing our very special relationship is better than having an enraged husband or a foreclosed bar. As a matter of fact, I think maybe you've already come to that realization.
There we are.
Ah, thank you.
Dan, we can't talk here.
Yes, you're right. My car's waiting outside. We can go right straight to the corporate apartment.
I'd like that.
Wonderful. Let's get your beautiful coat.
Oh, but I'm hungry. Can we have supper first?
All right. You can have anything you want. What's on the menu?
Oh, not here. I mean, I have to eat Maeve's cooking all the time.
I thought you said the food here was very good.
Oh, it's okay. It's just sort of uninspired. Let's go someplace more exciting. There's a Chinese restaurant just around the corner.
Well, that's wonderful. We'll make an evening of it. We'll have dinner and drinks.
Let's go.
Yes.
Maeve?
Yes, dear.
I'm gonna go. I'm taking Mr. Fox to Lem's. He loves Chinese food, and we have to discuss my portfolio.
Yes, it's going to need a great deal of attention. I'm glad I finally got to meet you, Mrs. Yes. Ryan. You have a wonderfully charming place.
Thank you.
Oh, this is solid mahogany, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
It's beautiful. I'll bet this piece alone is worth $50,000.
Well, let's go.
Oh, how much do I owe you for the drink?
It's on the house. Come on, let's go. We will never get a table. Goodbye, Maeve.
All right. Kevin. Goodbye.
Bye.
Uninspired, indeed.
Here you are. Drink it down.
No, I don't. What is it?
Cognac. For medicinal purposes only. Your nervous system will thank me. Come on. One gulp. Oh, come on now, all of it. There you go. There. Is that better?
I don't know.
Kim, your mother is going to be all right. Now, you believe me, don't you?
Yes.
You must be exhausted.
No, I'm not exhausted. I don't know. I just...
Go on.
I did this to her. I hurt her.
You didn't mean to.
She's gonna hate me when she finds out.
No.
She will. It was better when she didn't know me.
You don't believe that?
She's gonna send me back to my grandmother and I'll never see her again.
No, I doubt very much that that'll happen. Can't promise you, but when you explained to her what happened, you didn't mean it.
But I didn't mean it. I never thought it would be dangerous. It's just when you told me you were a little inhibited, I thought I could help. Hash can do that. You loosen up. You forget. I just wanted to see the two of you together. I thought it would make you happy. You believe me, please.
Yes, yes. But Kim, you have to understand that you have no right to meddle in people's lives like that, whatever your reasons. Do you understand why you did it?
No. I thought I did. I don't understand.
It's been very hard for you, hasn't it? I don't mean tonight.
Yes.
Have you ever thought of getting some help?
You mean like a psychiatrist?
Yeah. Maybe talking to somebody would...
I'm not crazy. I just wanted... You don't understand.
Kim, I'm not criticizing you.
You said
what I said was that maybe you need someone to talk to. Now, that doesn't mean you're crazy. It doesn't mean you're bad or anything else you might think. It hasn't been easy for you.
I'm all right.
Yes. Yes, you are. But I suspect there's a lot of things going on inside that you won't even let yourself see. But they're still there. And the longer you ignore them, the more trouble they're going to cause you. You love your mother very much, don't you?
Of course.
What does it feel like? Finding her again, spending time with her?
It's wonderful. It was. I dreamed about it for so long, and then...
Making up for all the years you missed.
I guess so. Maybe. I just wanted to see that she was right to let me stay.
Mm-hmm. How were you going to do that?
I don't understand.
You wanted to find someone for her. A man she could be with, possibly marry. And you could have a family, a real family.
You're mad at me.
No.
I just thought... I never knew my father. I never even knew who he was. No one would ever tell me. I used to walk down the streets in Topeka when I was little. Even now. And I'd look at the faces. Just the people that passed along the street. And sometimes I'd recognize something in their eyes. And I don't know what. And I'd think, are you him? Are you my father? And then when I met you and I saw how much you liked my mother, and you were the one I imagined. Well, it wasn't really you. But...
I understand.
I'm sorry.
I'm not. You're very tired.
Yeah, maybe.
I better get going, let you get to sleep.
No, wait. Please, I'm sorry. I don't want to be alone tonight. Please stay. I'm scared.
I can't.
Please. There are 4 bedrooms here. The guest room is always done up. Just for tonight, please.
All right.
Thank you. I don't mean to be such a baby, but... Thank you.
It's gonna be all right. Don't worry. Are you feeling better now?
Would you believe it? I'm still hungry. You mind if we order a little more?
No, I don't mind. Waiter, could we see the menu again, please?
Thank you. Let's see.
Delia, the gentleman is waiting.
Oh, I'm sorry. There's just so much here to choose from. Well... I think I'll have another order of mushu pork with extra pancakes. And, I guess just a side dish of crab meat of General Gao. Oh, wait a second. Would you make that shrimp with lobster sauce instead of the crab meat? And could you be sure it's well done? Thank you. Be careful with seafood.
I didn't know better. I would think this was a delaying tactic.
What do you mean?
Nothing, nothing. You just really must have been starved.
Oh, I am. See, I've been trying to lose weight. I went on this diet where you don't eat anything at all.
Nothing? Doesn't sound very healthy.
Oh, it's all right. A doctor prescribed it, but I haven't eaten for 2 days, and I just couldn't take it anymore.
No self-control, that's my problem.
Well, in some instances, that's considered a definite asset. You don't need to be on a diet. What are you talking about? You're absolutely perfect, just as you are.
Oh, no, I'm not. I'm not at all.
Oh, yes, you are. I just hope you leave us enough time. Maybe we should order the food to go.
No, it will get all cold and everything. And besides, once we get there, you don't want me to be thinking about food, do you?
No. But I also don't want to get to the apartment and then have you have to leave to go back to your husband. That wouldn't make me happy at all. And that wouldn't be good for either one of us now, would it?
Well, that's okay. Roger's at a meeting tonight, and I'll just leave him a message if it gets late. So don't worry.
I'm not. I am looking forward to a wonderful, long evening.
Dr. Coleridge.
Hello, Roger.
Can I get you something?
No, thanks. Actually, I was looking for my wife. I had a conference at Columbia tonight. It broke a little early, and I thought she might be here.
Well, as a matter of fact, she was, but she left some time ago.
Oh, I guess I just missed her. Thank you, ma'am.
Roger, she wasn't going home. She was with her broker. What was his name?
Dan Fox.
Yes, right. They seem to be hungry, and Delia apparently is not very satisfied with the cuisine around here these days, so they've gone over to Lem's. They left a hour or so ago, but you still catch them.